Chris Lally, you're going to be our first one, Lightning Talks, co-founder of Fide.
Cool. What's up? My name is Chris Lally. I'm the co-founder and CEO of Fide. What we do at Fide is we look at the backgrounds and reputations of Web3 projects and teams. Our team has been, for the past year, looking at the key factors that help us indicate the potential success of a Web3 project. So depending on your risk tolerance and how much time you have, you can obviously do your own research in many different ways. But today, I'll just cover three key things that we think that you should be looking at for any Web3 project. So we're going to cover the security of the project. We're also going to cover how the team communicates what's going to happen in the worst case scenario. And finally, we'll be talking about the accountability and the reputation of the team behind the project itself. So first, security. Many Web3 projects have a smart contract. And smart contracts, they have a lot of potential vulnerabilities, as we've seen with multi-million and hundreds of millions of dollars in hacks. So what's really important is to have a third party actually audit those smart contracts. If you don't see a Web3 audit on any smart contract and the smart contract is at the center of a Web3 project you're investing in, you should definitely be concerned. Now, just because it has an audit, we've also seen many auditors that claim to be auditors, but if you give them enough money, they'll give you the audit check. So make sure you check the reputation of the auditor themselves. Next, you want to be making sure that there's a bug bounty program set up for the Web3 project, because if the community has a chance and they're financially incentivized to check the Web3 smart contracts and any code behind the project, then you're going to be much less likely to have a bad actor exploit a potential vulnerability. So make sure you have the community find those vulnerabilities before the hackers do. Next, we're going to dive into the worst case scenario. And this kind of sounds counterintuitive. Like, why are we thinking about worst case scenario from the beginning? But what we've actually found is the teams that talk about the worst case scenario, they're the ones that are actually thinking ahead. They tell you what happens if they don't live up to expectations. There's often a treasury that's involved with the Web3 project. So what happens to that treasury? Is it going to get returned back to the community so that they can be at least partially made whole in the project they invested in? So if they don't have this treasury and if they don't have these factors in case, and you don't know what happens in the worst case scenario, then that's a really big indicator that might be a risky project. One other aspect to look at is vesting schedules. Vesting schedules essentially are milestones that the team has to hit in order to receive a reward. This is nothing new. It's been happening for startups for many years. And they only get equity after they've stuck with the company for a certain period of time and they've met certain milestones. We should be holding Web3 projects and teams to the same standard. And if they don't have these in place, then what's to say that they don't get the money? And maybe they had good intentions at the beginning, but if those intentions are met with a lot of money up front and then they see that there's a big risk that this project might not go well, why would they continue working on it? Why wouldn't they just take the money and run? So understanding upfront what happens if in the worst case scenario is a really good indicator if the project team is serious. Finally, we'll talk about the reputation and the accountability of the team itself. Now, the reputation of the team, you might be thinking, okay, a team has to have a lot of Web3 experience. But what we've seen is this is a new industry, and people that might not even have startup experience, they've been really successful in Web3 projects. So looking instead at the reputation of how honest and transparent the team members are, that's a much better indicator of how they're going to be in the future. So looking at that side of reputation, and then in terms of accountability, we've seen many anonymous founders in projects, and sometimes they can be successful. But looking at what founders have to lose is a really good indicator of if they're going to actually fulfill what they say they're going to fulfill. Now, if a team member is saying who they are and showing their face, it's a great indicator that you know they're putting their name and their brand behind the project. If they are anonymous and they haven't been building their anonymous pseudonym for many years, they haven't been building that reputation, then it might be a red flag, because not only might they actually scam and rug pull the project and leave, they might have done this several times in the past, and that's something that we've seen happen on-chain many, many times. So we covered just three pillars that you should be looking at. You should be looking at the security of the smart contract. You should be looking at the worst case scenario, if the team is communicating that clearly, what happens. And finally, you should be looking at the reputation and the accountability of the team. Now, our goal in Web3 is to make this place safer for everybody. We want experienced and new investors alike to know what they're walking into and be better informed. So I challenge you to help us hold Web3 projects to a higher standard. Thank you.